contact our destroyer. Tell them to stand by. Over, Hensley, press corps. I'm with the official party. Well, Larry, what's the big delay?
You've got to have new people waiting out there.
The plans have changed, Joe.
They've changed?
Let's just call it a security matter.
What about the motor gear?
Do me a favor, will you? Save the questions. Don't push. Don't play reporter. When it's time to release the story, I'll give you the whole scan.
I know that, Larry, but I take my word for it.
It's big enough to warrant a little patience, even from you.
Have the corridors clear.
Man who can keep peace at that conference. Remember what nearly happened first in 1971 and then last year?
What do we tell him, Mr. Secretary?
Tell him anything. Anything but the truth.
I only wish we could make arrangements with the local hospital.
That'd be a dead giveaway to the press.
Larry's right, Doctor. If this story leaks, we'll have an international panic on our hands. I hope your plan works. And the arrangements complete?
All set. He'll be transferred to a destroyer in the harbor. The copter's waiting.
He mustn't be airborne longer than 30 minutes. He wouldn't survive it.
How much time do we have, Doctor?
Well, without surgery, I give him about 36 hours at the most.
36 hours? And Washington still has to assemble the surgical team.
The destroyer will put to sea, meet the surgeons as close to home as possible.
Good.
That'll save a lot of time.
If it can be done in secrecy, it has to be done.
This isn't my life or yours, it's at stake. This happens to be Henry Talbot McNeil, the President of the United States.